Jeff Bezos is the world's richest person, but his nearly $200 billion net worth pales in comparison to the vast fortunes of the world's wealthiest historical figures. Many people suspect that Bezos will become the world's first trillionaire, but Genghis Khan and Augustus Caesar ruled over empires worth hundreds of trillions. John D. Rockefeller and Jacob Fugger were keen businessmen who had near monopolies in their respective industries. Here's a timeline of the richest people in history. Ancient era, Alexander the Great. Alexander the Great was only 20 years old when he became the king of Macedonia in 336 BC. He amassed incredible wealth ruling the ancient Greek kingdom, and when he died, his fortune was worth $500 billion adjusted for inflation. In 331 BC, he defeated King Darius III at the Battle of Gaugamela, despite being heavily outnumbered. Alexander pocketed 3,000 talents of gold in the process. To put that into perspective, one talent of gold equals the approximate weight of one man. The entire haul would be worth about $2.8 billion today. Augustus Caesar, 63 BC to 14 AD. Augustus Caesar founded the Roman Empire, and at the height of his power, he had a net worth of $4.6 trillion when adjusted for inflation. He owned half the empire and used his personal fortune to build architectural wonders like the Theater of Marcellus, Forum of Augustus, and the Temple of Mars Ultor. His wealth grew as the Roman army took over Dalmatia, Noricum, Raetia, and Pannonia. His conquests in Africa allowed the Roman Empire to take control of all of Egypt. That means he owned the entire country, including the Great Pyramids and the Sphinx. Despite spending 600 million silver denarii of his own money on public projects, Augustus lived a fairly modest life. He focused on politics and the military and had no desire for personal luxury. Emperor Shenzong of Song. He reigned from 1067 to 1085 and managed to amass a fortune worth $30 trillion when adjusted for inflation. During the Song Dynasty, China evolved into one of the world's premier economic superpowers thanks to expanded trade and technological innovations like movable type, gunpowder, and the mechanical clock. Despite being one of the richest people ever, Emperor Shenzong lived a very modest life. He practiced Confucianism and was an early proponent of the welfare state. Genghis Khan. Genghis Khan conquered most of Eurasia during his lifetime. His Mongol Empire spanned 12 million square miles, which means Genghis Khan had a fortune worth the equivalent of $100 trillion today. He devoted his life to battle and lived a predominantly nomadic life. Archaeologists have discovered remains of Genghis Khan's conquest beneath the ancient city of Karakorum. Silver, Chinese pottery, porcelain sculptures, and Muslim coins have all been discovered on site. Jacob Fugger. Jacob Fugger was so rich that his wealth accounted for 2% of Europe's GDP when he died in 1525. He was the savviest businessman in the Holy Roman Empire and amassed a fortune worth the equivalent of $500 billion today. When noblemen and clergy were in desperate need of cash, they would take out loans from Fugger. Fugger provided loans to the royal house of Habsburg and helped fund Magellan's costly circumnavigation of the globe. He even lent money to the Vatican to build St. Peter's Basilica and the Sistine Chapel. He personally designed a lavish mansion for himself, complete with palatial courtyard, mosaics, Tuscan marble, and water basins. John D. Rockefeller. With an inflation-adjusted net worth of $400 billion, oil tycoon John D. Rockefeller was the richest American of all time. By 1880, Rockefeller's Standard Oil controlled 90% of oil production in the U.S. And in 1913, his $900 million fortune accounted for 3% of the United States GDP that year. Rockefeller bought up competitors and drove down the price of oil when holdouts wouldn't sell. Standard Oil's near monopoly wouldn't sit well with the federal government, which passed the Sherman Antitrust Act and forced the company to break up in 1911. Rockefeller's fortune afforded him a lavish lifestyle. He spent thousands of dollars to have time and motion studies done on his golf swing, and he owned multiple residencies, including an estate in Lakewood, New Jersey, and a sprawling estate called Kikuit in upstate New York. Did you know that Rockefeller donated more than $500 million to various charities during his lifetime? He was inspired by fellow Gilded Age industrialist Andrew Carnegie, who gave away his entire fortune before his death in 1919. Carnegie had a peak net worth of about $350 billion adjusted for inflation. And he famously said, "The man who dies rich dies disgraced." That's it, folks. Thanks for watching.